Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to integrate third-party libraries into the SyncFusion Angular Rich Text Editor component. Looking at this example, the Rich Text Editor component is integrated with the Tribute.js and Embedly libraries. The Tribute.js library automatically suggests employee names in the pop-up when you type it in the RTE. Also, you can show a card preview for a provided link using the Embedly.js library. Okay, I will show you how to integrate third-party libraries into the Angular RTE using my existing Angular application. I open the Angular Rich Text Editor application, where I have added the RTE with the placeholder property. I also imported the required module and services from the SyncFusion EJ2 Angular Rich Text Editor package. Follow the link in the card or the description below to learn the basics of adding the Angular Rich Text Editor component to an Angular app. Now, I run this example using the command ng-serve. When you look at the editor, you will see the short description content and default toolbar items. Now, I will show you how to tag or address someone directly in the RTE component using the mentions library. First, I need to integrate the third-party mentions library, Tribute.js. So, I use this command, npm install Tribute.js, to install the Tribute.js library. As I have already installed it in my machine, I am skipping this step here. Next, I need to import the Tribute class from the Tribute.js library. Then, I navigate to the index.html file and add the CDN link of the Tribute CSS to reference the Tribute CSS styles in the application. Next, I need to create a matching list with a key-value pair. First, I need to define a created event with an appropriate event handler. Then, within this onCreate method, I define a variable of type Tribute and assign an array of objects with key and value fields. Here, I have bound employee names as the key and their short names as value. Next, I get the RTE instance by adding a reference variable, example RTE, and access it using the viewchild directive within this app component TS file. Then, I define a variable named RTE object of type rich text editor component to get the RTE instances. I imported the viewchild directive and rich text editor component class from Angular Core and SyncFusion EJ2 Angular Rich Text Editor to access the component instances. Now, I pass the RTE's input element to the attach method of the Tribute.js library. Also, I will change the placeholder value as type it to get the employee list. So now, looking at the rich text editor component, when the @mention is typed in the editor, the employee list is shown. Next, I am going to show you how to view a provided link as a card in the RTE. First, I include the Embedly script reference in the index.html file. Then, I add an action complete event with the appropriate event handler and define it within the app component TS file. Next, I need to create an element to display the card. So, let me add an if condition to check whether request type is links and define the variable embed card element of type HTML element. And create a block quote element using the create element method. For this element, I set the class name to embedly card using the set attribute. As I said before, I am going to show the provided link as a card, so I append the link's parent element to this paragraph HTML element. Finally, I need to insert this newly created element into the RTE, so I pass this embed card element to insert node method. See the output page now. When the link is inserted, the card preview is shown in the rich text editor component. Similarly, you can integrate other third-party libraries in the SyncFusion Angular RTE component. In this video, we have seen how to integrate the third-party libraries, Tribute.js, and Embedly into the rich text editor component. We saw how to open an autocomplete pop-up when the @symbol is typed in the editor. We also learned how to show a card preview for a provided link. If you would like to see the working example from this video, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description part below. You can also check if you qualify for our community license, giving you a free license key for our entire Angular suite, with the link in the description. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.